when we have our identity, that solar plexus is letting us know what our value is. It's letting us know what we're worth. And with that, our money story usually, if there's snags, if it's not positive, it's down in your root chakra. And so when we have negative ideas around money that we were given, whether from our family or culturally, I'm sure everyone can think of a show where the rich person on the show was greedy, they were bad, and it still happens. It doesn't matter if it was Gilligan's Island or something you're turning on the TV right now to. Like, I see my daughter watch little kids show, and the rich girl is the snobby one who's the bully, right? Every single time. It's like, why can't the rich kid be nice for once? Because it's culturally being subjected to us that if you have money, you're inherently bad. If you have money, you're going to be greedy. And therefore, it's training us to stay in the sameness. Meaning that if we all believed that we were worthy of wealth, if we were worthy of our greatness, if we knew that it was our divine right to have all of our physical needs met, our healthcare, everything met, then the government and everything else, especially in the US, would have some issues on their hands, right? And so it's a way of suppressing society by teaching us that being wealthy is bad. And let's just keep it up in that top 1%. Okay, so here we are, doing our money stuff, figuring out how we feel about money. And I think that's oftentimes the first step, is to feel into, what does money feel like? If you hear the terms rich, if you hear the terms wealth, how do you feel if I was to write you right now a $5,000 check and hand it to you, and you can see it, visualize it in your hand, what's your first reaction? Right? Is it, oh my God, no, you can't give that to me? Is it, hot damn, thank you, I feel so lucky, let's go out to dinner? You know, there's a difference. And so energetically, we are bringing our money stories to our money experiences. And so when we bring our money experiences with us without having worked on them, then we show up going, I don't know if I'm worth that. I don't know if I can accept that from you. I don't know if I can say yes to that. And so we have these money stories that need to be healed. Because when we can start rewiring and training our brains around money stories that serve us, man, does it feel good, right? And so how can we change the language around money? How often do you say, I don't have enough money? I don't have enough money for that vacation. I don't have enough money for that course. I don't have enough money for that coach. I don't have enough money, fill in the blank. And notice throughout a week, how often do you say, I don't have enough money, blank? Watch yourself, catch yourself, do that thought catching, and go, and how can you replace that? What can you change about that phrase that is going to teach the universe that you are willing to say yes to things, that you are worthy to having the stuff that you desire, having your goals be met?